Good evening, everyone. How are you tonight? Bravo, come on. How are you tonight? Welcome to our spirit concert. You are in for a treat tonight. It is going to be a little bit of a roller coaster, and I will not apologize for it. These kids have worked really hard this trimester, and they are going to knock your socks off. We are starting with Harmonia Jazz Choir. This group meets in the mornings at 7 a.m. twice a week. It'll be interesting to hear what they sound like at 7 p.m. I think it's a very different experience. The first piece we're going to do is originally a Bob Dylan song and was rewritten or redone by, Adele. Smith is my name. And then this particular arrangement was arranged by my sister, Jessica Fritz. This is To Make You Feel My Love. And then we're going to complete their set with The Shadow of Your Smile. Say their ages, did they have kids, It was a really fascinating experience to see them digging into that. This is the Shelton Farewell. We did this trimester, two of the choirs that you'll hear tonight, is a composition project. It's one thing for them to get the music that's already done and try to guess what the composer was thinking, or just sort of start from that point, but I actually had each of the kids in the classes compose their own music. They started by writing poetry. Some of them ended up finding their own, somebody else's poetry already online, but sort of making it their own. They put rhythm to it, they decided what the shape of the melody was going to be, and then eventually I gave them a major scale to work within, but they ended up writing some songs. So tonight, Concert Choir is going to sing two of those compositions. They're reading them, because we've just been working on singing them this week, but I wanted you to hear them. So the melody and the words were written by our composers. I'm improvising a little bit of a harmony, but these were two of the many finished products. The first one you're going to hear is called The Rose by Amy Vervoort, and the text is, "Whose rose is that? I think I know. Its owner is quite happy though, full of joy, like a vivid rainbow. I watch her laugh, I cry hello. The rose is soft, beautiful, and deep, but she has a promise to keep. After cake and lots of sleep, sweet dreams come to her to keep. The second piece we're going to sing is entitled Falling Apart, and this was written by Casey Woodward, and the text is this. It's getting colder, so is my heart. It's getting darker, so are my thoughts. The leaves are falling, and so are mine, falling apart. The ground is shaking, just like my faith. Feels like I'm wasting the years away. Stuck in a circle, forget my heart, falling apart. Please enjoy these two original compositions. Is going to do it for this portion of the concert is a gospel piece entitled Cornerstone. There's a lot of moving parts in this piece. There's a triple trio, there are two soloists, there's a desiccant singer, piano, clapping. It's a crazy vibe. So we hope you enjoy Cornerstone.
Through the winter's cold, only to rise back.
This group of lovely people is our treble choir. This is an auditioned ensemble. They might be small, but they be mighty. The first piece they did was entitled How Can I Keep From Singing, which is a traditional Quaker hymn. The next piece we're going to do, entitled Dance on My Heart, tells this fantastic story of this young lady. We imagine her to be sort of in Elizabethan times, where her name is Josephine. We gave her a name. And she's just minding her own business one day when these two rather men, one is rather pompous and one is rather full of himself, which I guess is the same thing, they decide that they're going to take her hand in marriage. And she says, thank you, next. And then a very kind gentleman comes along and says, I can't offer you anything. I'm not brave, I'm not wealthy, I'm not powerful, but I will be kind to you your whole life. And she says, yep, you're the one. So we hope you hear all five characters in this song, the narrator, the two not-so-great guys, the great guy, and Josephine. This is Dance on My Heart.
Thank you.
Trouble Choir is going to finish their portion of the concert tonight with another one of those gospel spiritual ones. You're going to hear a couple of those tonight. This one is entitled, "The Storm is Passing Over." And I love the message of this piece because it talks about no matter what's going on, no matter what we've been through, and all of us have been through something, there is light at the end of that tunnel. So we're going to finish with some clapping and some singing and hopefully a little dancing. And this is "The Storm is Passing Over."
Oh,
ladies and gentlemen, of Gloucester Choir. That first piece, mouth music, is a Celtic piece. It's meant to sort of be gibberish. It's meant to sound like instruments, inspire dancing, a little bit of reckless abandon. I think we finally got to abandon, maybe not reckless. But it's been really interesting for them to learn that. It's very different than anything else we've done this year. You will see in their four songs, we're going to do a lot of very different. The next piece we're going to do is a Stevie Wonder song. Makes perfect sense, right? This is Superstition. We added the cajon. A cajon is that. It's a really cool drum that you sit on to play. And we had a lot of fun working on this piece. So please enjoy Stevie Wonder's Superstition. Devastation that took place in that place. The best I could do for them is to show them some pictures of the time. So I think it's really hard for us to comprehend the place where this was written from. So it originally came then, it came back a few years later in the aftermath of Hurricane Katrina. It's a little closer to home, but still not something that we can necessarily grasp. It talks about an absolute pleading for mercy, for help. It talks about funeral fires, and in a funeral fire, releasing all of that pain and agony up to the spirit world, up to a place where we can start to heal. I think our area recently has suffered a great loss, and we can catch a glimpse. And there's a firefighter Lundberg, we can catch a glimpse of that. So we hope that you find some peace, some comfort in Requiem.
Thank you.
finished, I told you it was a roller coaster. We finished with a gospel piece. A gospel piece to end all gospel pieces, I feel like. We've had a little fun with this. This is Praise His Holy Name. For some reason, I thought it was a good idea to teach every choir how to clap. It wasn't. But they made me proud of it, so we'll see if this group can stick with that as well. This one's just a lot of fun. It's Keith Hampton. It's got a crazy cool piano part. Lots of clapping. You can clap along, but they'll keep you in time, so be careful, okay? This is Praise His Holy Name. While we're finishing today's set, that I want to Say, I want to say thank you to Dan Lauder. I want to say thank you to the administration here at Kaukauna High School and Kaukauna Schools, the music department, especially Jacob Martin, Kate Neesman, and Rosalind Bauer. My amazing accompanist, Kathy Allen. Let's give her a round of applause. Angela Agan, Beth Garland, and Julie Fisher, who help every day, but especially tonight, to make sure everybody is safe and accounted for and happy, even me. My fourth hour student aides throughout the year, Alyssa Chandler, Allie Pate, Lindsay Lamers, and Jake Van Aston. Parents, grandparents, families that support these kids in everything they do, it's appreciated. I also need to make a few recognitions. If you participated in solo and ensemble this year in February, would you please raise your hand? I took three of our really awesome male seniors to compete in the McDowell Male Chorus Scholarship Competition, and I'm really pleased to announce that DeAndre Benson took first place and won $1,000. I'm going to tell the story. We get there, the first kid that sings was incredible. He looks at me, Jerry looks at me and says, "Why am I here?" I can tell them now to win $1,000. This past Saturday, one of our other singers took home a Center Stage High School Musical Theater Award for outstanding performance by a supporting actress as Rosie in Mamma Mia, the one and only is about our band, choir, orchestra trip to New Orleans. We're always looking for chaperones. We also host solo and ensemble next year here in Kaukauna. Two different Saturdays, once for vocal piano, once for instrumental. So we'll be looking for volunteers. And last but not least, I would like to acknowledge the seniors, the class of 2019. If you look around the room tonight, you see several people with corsages on. These kids are amazing human beings. And it's not easy to get a new choir teacher when you're a senior. I did that when I was a senior in high school, too. It's not easy. Being a choir kid and a choir teacher, it's a different relationship. You spend 4 years together instead of maybe a trimester or a year. And it's hard. I know it's hard. And these kids have welcomed me with open arms. They have been positive, strong leaders, especially my fifth period crew. You know who you are. And they have been absolutely amazing. So can we please give them a round of applause? It's a Coldplay song. It's entitled Fix You, but it's a really special version of it that welcomes all of the singers that were on the stage tonight to perform together. I thank you for being here tonight. When we're done with this, we're going to let concert choir get out of the aisles first before the audience leaves. So this will be my final thank you to you tonight. I appreciate your support of these kids. I appreciate your support of this program. And I can't wait to see what's in store in the coming years. Thank you. This is Fix You.
All right, so I'll see if I can talk to this kind of last minute thing. But okay, first off, can we just get a round of applause for this beautiful woman here? And it took our Kaukauna like a champ. When she came in, she got stuff done. I'm not gonna lie. I am so proud of you for coming and taking on all of us crazies, because Kaukauna crazy, you know how it goes. I wish I would have more years to work with her as a choir teacher, because she's been such a phenomenal choir teacher. She's helped so much over this year, and I know a lot of the seniors didn't expect to have a different teacher, let alone like her at the beginning. I didn't. But yeah, so just thank you so much for coming in and helping us all out and just being such a great person. Thank you.
to.